Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to explain these two patterns. So I will be implementing two separate programs in C so that you will understand how these patterns to print digits in form of binary on output screen can be implemented. So before starting of the explanation, if you go to the details or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists, so you can follow them to watch various programming related videos. Now I'm going to explain the first pattern. So we need to understand the logic first. So here you can see we have multiple rows, right? And in each row we have digits either 1 or 0. So if we talk about first row, so you will see only 1 we need to print. Then in second row we need to print 1, then 0. Then in third row, we need to print 101. So here you can identify a common pattern, like at the starting of each row, we are going to print 1, then 0, then again 1, then 0. So it means if we are printing a particular row, so its odd positions will be printing 1 and its even positions are printing 0. So if we talk about this, row, so you can see all positions are printing 1 and even positions are printing 0. So this way we need to identify the logic. So here total 2 loops will be implemented. So one will be for rows and second will be for printing columns. So now I am going to implement those. So this is first loop. And this loop will repeat 5 times because we need to print 5 rows. If you want to print more than 5 rows, so here you can place a variable that you can read from the user. Now inside this, I'm going to write one more loop. And this loop will depend upon I. Because here you can see in each row, if we are on third row, we need to print 3 digits. If we are on fourth row, we need to print 4 digits. So the J loop will depend upon the I. So J will actually print the digits. And how many digits it has to print, that will be decided by the row number, and row number will be decided by the I. So after implementation, I will explain you each and every line or step so that you can understand how these loops are working and how this pattern will be printed. So now here I am going to apply one if condition. So if condition will be like, if J is having odd position, if J is having odd position or value, then we need to print 1, otherwise 0. So I am checking if J modulus 2 double equals to 0. So if value of J is completely divisible by 0, so it will print 0. Else it will print 1. Then after completion of this loop, I am going to print new line. So this way this implementation is complete, right? So now I am going to explain the complete execution cycle. So starting from here, initially I is 1, then control will transfer here to J loop. So here you can see condition is J less than equals to I and I is 1. So this loop will repeat only one time. So value of I is 1. Divide 1 by 2, so it is not divisible. So control will transfer to else. Else will print 1. So this way, this 1 will be printed. Now, after completion of this loop, this printer will transfer control to new line. So cursor will be available to new line. Now, I plus plus. So this time, I will become 2. And this J loop will repeat 2 times. So first time, value of J is 1. So check 1 modulus 2 divisible by completely divisible or not. So if it is equals to 0, then it is completely divisible, but 1 is not completely divisible by 2. So again 1 will be printed. Then J plus plus will take place because this time J is repeating 2 times. So 2 modulus 2. Now this will provide remainder as 0. So 0 equals to 0 will be true. So it will print 0. So you saw J has been repeated 2 times. After completion, printer will print new line, so control will be transferred to third line. Now I will again increment, so its value is 3, and J will repeat 3 times. So first, second and 3. So initially it will be 1, then this condition will be false, so it will print 1. When J will be 2, the condition will be true and it will print 0. When J will be 3, its condition will be false and again it will print 1. So this way, based on value of J, we are deciding whether to print 0 or 1. So if J is having odd values, we are printing 1. And if J is having even values, then we are printing 0. So this way, you understood how this pattern is printed on output screen with the help of this program. Now coming to the second pattern. So here you will see one more change. First, third, and fifth rows are starting from 1. Then after starting 1, they are printing 0, then 1, then 0, and then 1. Right? If we talk about this second row and fourth row, so they are starting from 0, then printing 1, then 0, and then 1. So this way they are behaving. So it means we need two conditions here. Like we are printing odd row or even row. And then we need to decide we are printing odd column or even column. So in this, we only decided that whether we are printing odd column or even column, because we decided it vertically. So vertically, we need to identify columns. So we identified which column we are printing, even or odd. But rows are printing similar kind of values. But here, each row, or you can say, even rows are starting from 0 and odd rows are starting from 1, and then they are printing 1, 0 continuously. So this way we need to apply different logic here. So I am going to implement that. So again, these two loops will be enough, but we need to apply one more condition here. So this I is pointing to the row and J is pointing to the column. So if we are inside J, so first we need to apply this. So this if and else, right? So this is a block and this is another block. So here we are dividing I by 2. If I is completely divisible by 2, it means we are on even row. Otherwise, we are on odd row. Now, if we are on even row, so we need to first print 0 and then print 1. So 0, 1, 0, 1. So if we see the column, so odd columns are printing 0 and even columns are printing 1. So inside this, I am applying this logic. If J is divided by 2 and its remainder is equals to 0, so then we need to print 1. So here inside printf, I am printing 1, and else I am printing 0. And again, implement this here. So if J modulus 2 double equals to 0, so this is for odd rows. This is for odd rows. So here you can see if J is completely divisible by 2, then we need to print 0, otherwise 1. So with this if, I am going to print 0, and if we write else, so here we need to print 1. So this way, this loop is completed, and after this, I need to write one printf so that we can print new line, and then first loop will be completed. So this is I loop, this is J loop, and inside J loop, we have two parts so that we can print this pattern. So now I am going to explain this. Let's say I am going to print this fourth row and this fifth row, right? So if I am going to print fourth row, so you will understand one logic. If I am going to print fifth row, so you will understand another logic. So let's say I is 4. Let's say I is 4 and 1, 2, 3, first, second, third rows are already printed. For explanation purpose, I am explaining one even row and one odd row. So let's say I is 4. So J will start from 1 and it will go to 4. So J will repeat totally 4 times, right? Now, when J is 1, let's say J is 1, so we will go inside the loop, check this condition, I modulus 2, so I is 4. It means we are printing even row. So if I is successfully divisible by 2, then we need to run this if, otherwise else. So in this case, I will be divisible by 2. So when I is even, so this block will run, and when I is odd, so this block will run, right? So I is 4, so every time this block will run, and here we need to check the value of J. So right now J is 1, which is not divisible by 2. So what will be printed? 0, and we want 0. Then J will be incremented, it is 2. Again check this if condition, it will be true, because I is 4. So check this, J is 2, so 2 modulus 2, remainder will be 0. So this time 1 will be printed. Again J will be incremented, J is 3. So this time condition will be false, so 0 will be printed. Again J will be incremented, so it is 4, so 4 modulus 2, result will be equals to 0, so 1 will be printed. So when I is even, so this if will work, and accordingly J will be checked. If it is completely divisible, then 1 will be printed, otherwise 0. So here you can see on even position 1s are printed and odd positions are printing 0. Now this loop will complete after repeating 4 times, new line will be printed, then I plus plus, and this time I is 4. Sorry, this time I is 5. So J loop will repeat 5 times, and if J is repeating 5 times, so every time value of I will be 5, and 5 is odd number, so it means this condition will be false, and this else block will run now. This else block will run now. So in case of I, if it is odd, so this else block will run. So again, we need to start J from 1. So if J is 1, so we are on else. 1 modulus 2, it is not divisible, so it will be printing 1, so we want 1. Then J will be 2, so 2 is completely divisible, so it will print 0. Then again J will be incremented, so this time J is not divisible, so again 1. So this way all these values will be printed. So you can see here we are printing 1, 0, here we are printing 0, 1. So we are just switching the result according to the value of J. So this block is for even rows and this block is for odd rows, and this way if you implement this complete program, so this kind of pattern will be displayed on output. So I hope with this explanation you have understood how this these patterns will be printed on output screen. So if you want to watch more programming related videos, you can go to details and description of this video. There you will find links of various playlists, so you can watch them. And those playlists are also available on my channel, so do watch them. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.